pops it over the left side. Devontae wide open. Outside the numbers 20. Cuts it back right. Pass forward. 10 to the 5. To the end zone. High stepping. Touchdown. Devontae Adams.
Here's Jimmy Garoppolo. First and goal. 3 yard line. Throws. It is caught by Kendrick Bourne.
Rushes on. Wilson is head upset. It is Preston Smith with a huge play. A mega play by Preston Smith.
They get a Coleman off the left side. Touchdown! San Francisco!
I feel great, baby!
San Francisco! Hosting another one on Championship Sunday. Welcome back to Good Morning Football. Peter Schrager, Kyle Brandt, Nate Burleson, and myself, Kay Adams. We've got a huge announcement, a huge honor that we'll be talking about throughout the show today in regards to the Hall of Fame. So stay tuned for that. Will Selva's out in the newsroom in Culver City. Will, take it away.
All right. Thank you, Kay. Guys, happy Monday to you and happy Monday to everybody who's watching us. Let's get you caught up on some non-playoff news in the form of coaching hires. And it didn't take long for Pat Shurmur to find a job. No, not as a head coach, but as an offensive coordinator. He'll be the OC for the Broncos. Now, the move came at the expense of Rich Scangarello, who was fired after one season. Now, according to NFL Network's Mike Garofolo and Ian Rappaport, the deal isn't done just yet, but Shurmur already made his decision, Shurmur becoming the fifth offensive coordinator in 5 seasons in Denver. Now, Shurmur's former team hiring Patrick Graham as their defensive coordinator, as reported by NFL Network's Tom Pelissero. Graham holding the same position with the Dolphins. Graham and new head coach Joe Judge were both on Bill Belichick's staff for 3 seasons. Never a hair out of place. Jimmy Johnson is in the Follicle Hall of Fame, and for that I'm jealous. Bez Du on the sideline. He also was a great coach, and he's finally being rewarded for it. Hall of Fame president David Baker there giving Johnson the news on the set of Fox's halftime show. He has 2 Super Bowl victories to a resume that includes an 89 and 68 record. Congratulations to him, and congratulations to former Steelers head coach Bill Cowher as well. Cowher getting the news of his induction, just like JJ, on TV for CBS's NFL Today show. Cowher had 9 seasons of at least 10 wins, 10 playoff seasons, and of course, a Super Bowl win. Nate, you were there for Cowher's announcement. Give it to us. How was it like to be there to see Cowher get the news?
It was unbelievable. Shout out to the CBS crew, Drew Kalisky, our producer. He didn't tell us. Only person that knew was Phil Sims, who was doing our eye vision at the big board. And then as I'm walking back to my seat, looking at my notes, getting ready for my next block, I peek up just to hear what they're saying because there was a pause. And I see David Baker, who you cannot miss because he's a massive individual. And it hit me. I was like, whoa. He's about to get the news. And then I saw it just wash over his face. And Bill Cowher, he is one of the best trash talkers. We're very competitive on the set. First time I seen him, at a loss for words. And then his wife, his daughter. And it was an incredible, incredible moment. You know, just to be around Hall of Famers. I'm blessed to have played with Randy Moss and a few other individuals. So now I get to work with a guy every Sunday that's going to have a gold jacket in his closet. So sometimes you just sit by people and they rub off on you. So I'm honored to know him. And it's been a wonderful couple of years, and he's well deserving of it.
You get that lump in your throat, don't you? All the awesome football action this weekend, we watched it, and I got dusty as hell. Really, really did.
You see Troy Aikman, I'm crying on my plane.
It was
watching
a great, like, emotional thread throughout the weekend of football.
Yeah, and you know, to Nate's point, we're going to talk about the Hall of Fame. Just from an inside baseball, you guys, we work on a TV show. To keep that secret from both Bill Cowher and Jimmy Johnson, shout out to those production crews also, because that moment is spoiled if both those guys know that's what's about to happen.
Yep. Are we going to get emotional on Wednesday?
Yeah.
We're announcing more and more picks. More and more. David Baker might be in our studio.
Maybe so. Yep. Let's get ready. It's a big Wednesday for us right here in Good Morning Football. Were the Tennessee Titans kept a secret kind of backstage? Let's find out, because if you haven't been paying attention, here's the baddest man on the planet. Oh, my gosh. Look at that look, and there's the MVP. Let's see how this goes, though. First quarter, no score. The Ravens going to run all over them. They've been in their beds for a few weeks. Tannehill, Jonnu Smith. Oh, what a catch. Are you kidding me with this? One hand, toe drag.
Butt drag, really.
Butt drag, swag. Get that cheek down.
What did Ian Eagles say? Very cheeky moment here.
Absolutely right. Second quarter now. Lamar on the sideline. First and 10. Watch Tannehill right here. Who's he going to? Khalif Raymond is in the building. Second career touchdown. Welcome to the playoffs, Khalif Raymond. Ryan Tannehill going to the title game, just like we all said in August. Third quarter, fourth and inches. The Ravens go for it second time in the game. Not going to work there. Not going to work there. Stuffed them. Guys, they were 8-for-8 on fourth and one this year, 0-for-2 in this game. Lamar's like, what the heck's going on out here? And now we got this man. Give it to Atlas. Third and one. He's out the door. You get him down, he will house this thing. He will house it. Oh, no. Marcus Peters finally gets him. Guys, Derrick Henry went over 30 carries again. He almost hit 200 again. Baddest man on the planet right now. 14-6. Mariota's in the game. Direct snap to Henry, who's going to run it up the middle. No, wait. Tebow. Touchdown. Corey Davis. Unbelievable. Are you kidding me?
Third down. How about the stones of calling that? Arthur Smith, the offensive coordinator.
They said he missed it a lot in practice, Derek. Because we had to do extra practice.
That was
practice.
A Heisman package. Maybe it was a little to the Ravens.
Maybe it was. Off of Tebow, another Heisman winner. Jarrell Casey, who's a great friend of the show, strips Lamar. There were interceptions, there were fumbles, and there were smiles for the Tennessee Titans, who win again, who in back-to-back weeks have potentially ended the Patriots dynasty and knocked off one of the strongest number one seeds we've seen in years, both on the road, 28-12. And if you thought the party was over there, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Tajay Sharpe introducing his MVP. Come see him.
NFL rushing leader. If anybody got a problem with that, you come see me. We bout that. Big trust. Whoop, whoop. King Henry in the flesh. Whoop, whoop.
It's a great win today. We're advancing. Don't want to think too far ahead. I'm just glad that we were able to, you know, win this game against a great team and, you know, advance to the AFC Championship. Enjoy this win tonight. Get started tomorrow.
Derrick Henry's Titans will be going to Arrowhead to face those Chiefs on Championship Sunday. That is Sunday at 3 p.m. Eastern on CBS. The Packers face the Niners after that in the NFC for the ship, 6:40 p.m. Eastern on Fox. This was an incredible, really exciting win that we've seen ever since Tannehill took over this squad. And they take down the number one seeded, well-rested Ravens. Impressive performance by Tennessee all along and all around. Nate, what stood out to you the most and what impressed you most?
Impressive? Nah, this was dominant. Derrick Henry is a monster. Listen, the big question is, you know, is this sustainable? Is this sustainable? I remember one guy at this table asking last week, you know, is this sustainable? You know, it's not sustainable.
Yeah,
listen, things that aren't sustainable, what, college kids partying too much. You know, your 2020 diet for your New Year's resolution,
nah,
that's not
happening.
Sustainable.
Nah.
You know what's sustainable? Hard-nosed football.
Okay.
I'm talking old school. Give it to the biggest, fastest, strongest dude on the field 30-plus times and watch him run over everybody. And another guy at this table, name rhymes with Schrager. He said, prisoner of the moment. We've been every week. Don't be a prisoner of the only thing prisoner about this is when you put him in the hole, he goes crazy.
Yep.
And that's exactly what he does. He's driving defenses crazy, and he's unstoppable. Derrick Henry is a beast. And like I said before, I'll say it again. If you ride Derrick Henry, you can ride all the way to Miami.
This is 2020. You can't just have a big old lumbering running back. You can't keep giving him 30 carries every week. This is blasphemy. This is madness. This is the Titans. Boom! Again, they did it right up the middle. It's like we keep hearing all this stuff about, oh, you know, you're never going to see another Lamar. You're never going to see another Mahomes. I don't know. Maybe you are. There's a lot of great athletes coming up. Are you ever going to see 30, 30, 30 every single week? Are you ever going to see someone as erudite and intelligent as Peter Schrager week after week saying, guys, it's the Titans. Let's not be prisoners of the moment. Peter, you got your metal cup, and you're going up and down the bars. Are you getting paroled now? Are you going to come join the party in the yard?
It's not that it's the Titans. It's that it was the Ravens. The Ravens had the best rushing attack in NFL history.
It's really hard for me to resist just saying the Titans are amazing because
nobody knows.
When you go in to New England, then you go into Baltimore, you can't in good faith sit in this seat right here and say that the Titans aren't the real deal. And yet,
and it what?
My takeaway was, what a defensive performance. Fourth and one. The Ravens were 8-8 all season long. Second quarter, up 7-0. Fourth and one. The Titans defense is 8-for-8 on fourth downs. take this and shove it. Then we go back later, coming out of halftime, 14-6. The very first play after that, by the way, was the Raymond touchdown. So they're not only stopping you on fourth down, then they're using their passing game. Then, third quarter, Ravens, they decide to go for it, stuff them again. Like, this isn't just Derrick Henry, because their defense is unbelievable as well. They stuff these guys, and they did it last week to New England, too. So many goal line stands. And I love this. They make that stop. It's 14-6. All right, well, we got them in where we want them, right?
Yeah.
Derrick Henry, the next drive. Get out of here.
Yep.
They won the moment, Triggs.
Get out of here!
Yeah.
This dude is amazing. I mean, he took Earl Thomas and not only stiff-armed him, he stiff-armed him twice and then for good measure, for no reason, just tossed him one more time.
Can we see it? Can we see what Pete is referring to? The act of violence was committed on a potential future Hall of Famer, Earl Thomas. Come on, roll it. Give it to me.
Somebody said that he stiff-armed Earl Thomas so hard, he turned him into a lead blocker.
That's right. He did. Watch it. So he's got the angle, and he said, you, 29, get out of here.
This one here, though. Block!
Oh, baby.
Block for me. You block my...
If you're not going to tackle me, you might as well turn around and make yourself useful. Block somebody for me. Earl's like, okay, I got you. Watch. I'm going to take out my own guy. He's now running with him like a bobsled team. Oh, it's so good.
I like that you brought up the defense. When you look at the numbers, they gave up 530 yards this defense, but they won the moments. They won on those fourth and one stops, on the forced fumble, on the Derrick Henry trick play, on the pick right in the beginning of the game. They won the big moments, and if they can continue to do that, they'll keep winning. I didn't think they'd win because I said Tannehill's going to have to throw, and he made some beautiful throws in this game. He's now the first quarterback to win back-to-back playoff games with under 100 passing yards since Terry Bradshaw did it in 1974.
You don't have to throw when you got a running back like that.
I'm
trying to tell y'all.